So what you'll see here is that from the U.S. government, what I want to leave you with is that there's exponential demand when it comes to cloud computing. And this view that we're shifting from asset ownership to service provisioning is a fundamental shift for the government, especially in the context of the $20 billion that we've identified. What you see before you is actually a set of categories as we sat down with agencies to identify, you know, what's first order, second order, third order in terms of the demand side. Well, number one, when it comes to collaboration, a lot of agencies are very, very focused on collaboration. So whether that's something as simple as email or whether they're looking at office productivity tools, that's moving very fast to the cloud. Second side, when it comes to demand, is workflow. And this varies, you know, from employment verifications, grants management, all the way to claims processing and customer relationship management. A lot of agencies are actually investing and have begun moving in this direction. The third area is infrastructure. Agencies want to abstract the entire infrastructure because they want to move away from managing those 2,094 data centers to actually working on what really matters, which is serving their customers, the American people. So we're seeing a lot, you know, from something as simple as a website to agencies that want to virtualize everything. They don't want to be in the infrastructure business. They want to consume it very much like electricity as far as the utility is concerned. We're seeing that in terms of, especially in the, when it comes to app dev and testing. A lot of agencies have already begun that. You know, Department of Transportation is a perfect example that's looking at some of these areas. Business intelligence is another hot area. From a BI perspective, you know, whether it's data analytics or performance management, just given the challenges of big data, the ability to slice and dice and cube all this information and turn data into intelligence, huge migrations happening on that front. And lastly, information security, which was a surprise, you know, as I looked at this data and we were pouring through it. So a lot of agencies are actually also interested in figuring out what are some of the cloud solutions available to managing the complex enterprise as they see an explosion in mobile computing. And as many agencies think about and we look at the world changing before us, as we predict the death of the PC and more people, you know, moving to mobile devices that need to be provisioned on a real-time basis, and a fundamental shift in terms of, you know, the level of unhappiness with enterprise software. You know, every customer I talk to within the government, that they hate enterprise software. Yet, when you talk to them about what they do in their everyday lives, there's this huge technology gap. And what ends up happening is when people come into their government offices, they feel like they're going back in time because at home they have far better access to technology. And that's the technology gap that we're trying to close. And this $20 billion opportunity is before you. And my challenge to all of you today is, you know, for the good of the Republic, what I'd like for you to do and your companies is to come in and compete and introduce Darwinian pressure in Washington so that we can benefit, the American people can benefit, so your government can better serve you. And there are a number of issues that are going to be addressed, you know, as we move forward, whether it's in security or whether it's around the global framework we're looking at. But I think this is a one-way street, and the U.S. government is committed to making sure that in these tough economic times, when you look at on something as simple as email, you can save $20+ million. Imagine what happens when we go after that $80 billion and the opportunity to crack down on wasteful spending, but most importantly, unleash the innovative spirit of what's going on right here. Thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you and talking about a lot of these innovations.